Hi, my name is Nuno and welcome to the final video regarding all you need to know about 3D audio. Over the last videos we have been talking about the main flavors of 3D audio. We have talked about channel-based audio from stereo to 5.1 and 7.1 and 22.2 if you want 24 speakers in your living room. Okay, we have talked about also object-based audio and trying to understand a little more what is Dolby Atmos. We have talked about Emisonics, that is widely used nowadays for several applications, especially in VR. And we have talked about binaural and 3D sound over headphones. There are a few formats and systems that we didn't mention. For instance, we didn't talk about wave field synthesis. That is a system that allows you to have literally hundreds of speakers around you and get a sense, even almost a sound coming using speakers, but very close to you. So it's a very interesting one, but very, as you can imagine, having hundreds of speakers are not for every setup. And also there is a lot of people that now try to create things like having binaural but not with headphones, with speakers, and having speakers or sound bars that pretty much give you a sense of 3D sound even if you don't have speakers around you. Nonetheless, the main four we have talked about: channel, objects, emisonics, and binaural. So in terms of all of these formats, all of them has advantages and disadvantages, okay? There isn't one single approach that is better for every kind of application. All of them have advantages and disadvantages. My recommendation is to open an open mind and be able to understand all of those formats and see for each situation what is the best format that you want to use. Because in some situations, channel-based audio is definitely the best one, and others, it's probably objects or emisonics or binaural. So it depends a lot. And sometimes we tend to have almost like these lovers of technology A and B. And sometimes it feels that we are having almost like religious kind of discussions. No, Dolby Atmos is the best. And the others say, no, it's emisonics. And sometimes are not about technical things. It's things almost like politics, open source versus profit companies and other things. So open mind, understand that every single format has advantages and disadvantages. And if you know the advantages and disadvantages of each one of those formats, you are able to take the most out of all of them. Also, many applications tend to use hybrid approaches where actually you mix some of these things that we've been talking. For instance, in Dolby Atmos, you have objects and you also have beds. You have object-based audio and channel-based audio working together. And some tracks, some sounds end up as objects and some will end up as beds. And it's perfect. Or eventually you have setups where you convert channel, object, or ambisonics into binaural and you say, no, we start this as a format. For instance, VR applications, you start as ambisonics to do all the rotations and all of those things, but then you convert this binaural because people using an headset for VR will probably be using headphones. So sometimes this hybrid approach, it's very interesting and once again allows you to even overcome the cons on some of the technologies and give you a much better solution in the end. So now I hope you have a much better understanding of 3D audio. Once again, feel free to download our ebook, All You Need to Know About 3D Audio, that is available for free at soundparticles.com. And if you love 3D sound, of course, feel free to try our products from Sound Particles that allow to create thousands of sounds around you. And even if you are using channel-based audio, emisonics or other approaches, you can test it. Or if you are more, for instance, into music, not much as sound design, and you want to create things with exploring space as a new dimension, the same way that you use melody and harmony and rhythm and orchestration, you can also use space to have a new dimension and bring much more life into your mixes. And we have a series of plugins that you can try in our website. So once again, I hope you have enjoyed this series about 3D audio. I hope that you have a better understanding, and I'm looking forward to see the fantastic things that you are going to create in 3D audio. So welcome to this fantastic journey, and welcome to Sound Particles.